Some remittance firms are already facing difficulty dealing with foreign banks and counterparts. Bangko Sentral Deputy Governor Nestor Espinilla revealed at Tuesday's Senate hearing the $81 million money laundering scandal may aggravate the situation and hurt the reputation of local financial institutions.
The Philippines actually is experiencing increasing difficulty in terms of remittance flows because of the perception of problems of weak environment in the country in terms of our money laundering. And a situation like this can conceivably make that even harder.
Last February, $81 million stolen from the Bank of Bangladesh found its way into casinos in the Philippines through RCBC in a span of a few days. Senator Ralph Recto is optimistic $30 to $34 million may still be recovered, about $15.5 million from casino junket operator Kim Wong and $2.3 million from Solaire. Recto is convinced some $15 to $17 million remain with Philrem.
As far as I'm concerned, basta may nawawalang 15 at nasa Philrem yan sa tingin ko. Ang sabi nila, binigay nila, pero hindi totoo yan because they never saw Wee Kang Soo. They were transacting with Kim Wong. That is not true.
Philrem has denied keeping a portion of the loot. It said it delivered 600 million pesos and $18 million to Wee Kang Soo on instructions from RCBC branch manager Maya Degito, a claim Degito denies. At the last Senate hearing, she blamed RCBC senior officials taking part in laundering the stolen funds.
I am but a pawn in a high-stake chess game played by giants in international banking and high finance. If this committee is looking for the grandmaster, it is not me.
Senator Sir Chosmenia sees Degito's statement as an indication she could be setting herself up to be a state witness. Laws provide that a state witness must not appear to be the most guilty in a crime. Although Degito earlier rejected the offer to be placed under witness protection, her lawyer says she is keeping her doors open to the idea of being a state witness. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.